My name is Brian Manwaring, and I am owner of Florence's Exquisite Candies in Rexburg, Idaho. And I've been owner for about 10 years now. Bought it from my parents. So it happened back in 1981, and it was during the Carter years when the interest rates were high. My dad used to do trusses with his brother, and so he was in the construction business. And he got laid off because of the high interest rates, because the demand was low. My mom used to make candy out of her house for her family and friends, and so they decided to take his business knowledge and what she does for candy making and combine it as a business.
And we said, if we're going to do it, we're going to be the best. And what a lot of our friends said, you won't do any good back here because you're hidden. I said, word will travel, just wait and see. And so that's how we got started.
The thing that makes us a little bit different is I believe the centers of the chocolates are a lot more creamy. We use quality products, and we also have a good quality chocolate. And so I think between those two things, also that it's made here in Rexburg and it's all hand done, and so I just believe it's a much superior product to other chocolate manufacturers. What it involves is first you have to cook the product, and then we put it in what's called a cream beater, and that stirs around like a plow, if you've seen that in Rexburg, Idaho. And we add like the different ingredients. We can add the raspberries if we're doing raspberries, or oranges, and then the coloring. And so it mixes up in the cream beater. Once it's done in there, then we store it in the cooler, and then as we need it, then they bring it out and they hand roll it, and then it's dipped. And then once it's dipped, it dries and it's ready for packing. Without customers, you know, we don't have a living, and so it's always meant a lot. And like I say, we've been in the business for 32 years, and we appreciate all the patronage of the community and for the way that they've supported us throughout the years. And we try to be nice and kind and build relationships of trust with them. And when they come in, hopefully we know their names. We don't know everybody's names, but we try to know them and make it more personal.